Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and other top stories. We are talking to you on Wednesday, 3rd of July. Don't add fuel to fire. PM Modi warns of conflict in Manipur. Survivors recount horror of India stampede that killed over 120 people. And Taliban should not be ignored as Afghanistan's ruler says Russia will do it. And now for all the details. Speaking on the motion of hands to the residents, addressing the Raja Sabha, India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi affirmed that central government is making efforts to normalize the situation in the northeastern state of Manipur, which has been witnessing ethnic violence since last year. PM Modi, attacking the opposition Congress party, stated that it had imposed precedent rule in Manipur 10 times. He further called on the opposition leaders to cooperate with the government to restore peace in the state.
Manipur ki sthiti samanya karne ke liye सरकार निरंतर प्रयासरत है. वहां जो कुछ भी घटनाएं घटी, 11,000 से ज्यादा एफआईआर की गई है. मणिपुर छोटा सा राज्य है, 11,000 एफआईआर की गई है, 500 से ज्यादा लोग अरेस्ट हुए हैं. आदरणीय सभापति जी, इस बात को भी हमें स्वीकार करना होगा कि मणिपुर में लगातार हिंसा की घटनाएं कम होती जा रही है.
Meanwhile, the opposition lawmakers staged a walkout, blaming that the leader of the opposition, Mallikarjun Kharge, was not allowed to speak. Kharge said, Modi has a habit to mislead people and say things beyond truth. PM Modi said, they are running away as they cannot hear the truth. The BJP-led NDA formed its third successive government following the Lok Sabha polls. While the ruling NDA alliance won 293 seats, the opposition India Bloc won 243 seats.
और उनकी आदत है कि झूठ बोलना, लोगों को भ्रमित करना और जो सत्य के परी जो विरोध में बात करना, ये उनकी आदत है. और मैंने सिर्फ उनको इतना ही पूछा कि जब वो संविधान के बारे में बोले कि आज लोग संविधान के लिए बचाने के लिए डंडोरा पीट रहे हैं, ऐसी बात उन्होंने कही, तो हमने ये कहा, देखो संविधान तो आप नहीं बनाए, संविधान के आप विरोधी थे.
In a tragic incident, at least 121 people lost their lives and 35 were injured on Tuesday in a stampede at a Hindu religious congregation in Hathras district of northern India. A police report said the number of people present at the event was more than triple the permitted capacity. Most of the dead were women along with several children, according to state officials. The report described a scene of utter chaos when the preacher at the congregation, Suraj Pal, also known as Bhole Baba, was leaving in his car. Thousands of devotees shouted and ran towards the car, crushing others still sitting in the gathering. Some people also fell into an adjacent field of slush and mud and were trampled there. Survivors from the incident recounted the horror and chaos at the event and said anyone who fell did not get up, was trampled by the crowd and died.
सत्संग खत्म होते ही एकदम भगदड़ मची है. जो इंसान गिर गया वो उठो ही ना, फिर कुचल कुचल के सब मर गए.
अस्पताल में मेरी बेटी सही आई है बिल्कुल, और उनके लिए मेरी बेटी ने पानी भी पिलाया है, सबको पानी डाला है सबके मुंह में. और तब मेरी बेटी ने फोन किया है कि मामा मैं अस्पताल में आ गई हूँ, तो कहते जब तक मेरे भाई जी पहुंचे तब तक वो मेरी बेटी खत्म मिली है.
Police forensic teams on Wednesday conducted investigations at the site of the deadly stampede. Forensics personnel and police with sniffer dogs were seen collecting evidence. A case has been filed against the organizers, but not the preacher.
देखिए बड़ी ही दुखद घटना है और हाथरस में जिस तरह से रात भर हम सब लोग हर एक चीज़ की अपडेट लेते रहे हैं अभी तक जो मृतक लोगों की संख्या है वो बड़ा ही दुखद है और 121 लोग अभी तक जिनकी पुष्टि हो गई है जो मृतक हैं और 35 लोग लगभग घायल थे।
Moving on, Pakistan's minority Christian community on Tuesday held a protest in Karachi against the death sentence awarded by a court to a Christian man for sharing blasphemous content on social media. A report.
Dozens of men and women from Pakistan's minority Christian community on Tuesday staged a protest in Karachi against the death sentence awarded by a court to a Christian man over blasphemy charges. A court in the city of Sahiwal in Punjab province on June 29 sentenced Ehsan Shan Masih to death for sharing blasphemous content on social media after a mob attacked on Christians last year in Jaranwala. The protest was organized by the Christian Community, Minority Rights March and Civil Society outside Karachi Press Club.
डिमांड हमारी सदर पाकिस्तान से सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ पाकिस्तान से आर्मी चीफ से और वजीर आजम पाकिस्तान से है कि इस बच्चे को फौरी तौर पर इंसाफ दिया जाए इस केस को फिर फौर खत्म किया जाए और जिन लोगों ने दर हकीकत जड़ावाला में तबाहकारी की मजहबी दहशत गर्दी की उनको वाकई सजा दी जाए।
ये जो शान मसीह साहिवाल एंटी टेररिज्म कोर्ट ने उसको सजाए मौत सुनाई है इस फैसले से हम मुतमिन नहीं हैं और ना सिर्फ पाकिस्तान की सारी अकलियतें बल्कि मसीही जहाँ जहाँ आबाद हैं उन तक ये फैसला पहुँचा उन्होंने सदाए एहतजाज बुलंद किया।
In August 2023, a Muslim crowd vandalized several churches and set scores of houses on fire in Jaranwala after accusing two members of the Christian community of desecrating the Quran. Police and residents said the attack started after someone took allegedly desecrated pages of Quran to a mosque prayer leader, which was followed by announcements calling for punishment.
Meanwhile, residents in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir have demanded urgent road repairs. They blame the administration has been neglecting infrastructure development and that no funds were allocated for it in the recent budget.
Locals in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir have lamented poor road connectivity is affecting their daily lives and the tourism-dependent economy of the region. They blame the administration.